In today's Axure tutorial, we are going to have a look at repeaters. We're not going to do anything fancy with them, but we are going to use them for styling a simple list. This is the repeater widget. Double-click to edit the repeater. By default, the repeater only contains one box. We'll delete it for now and replace it with an image, title, text, and a call to action button, which will be our list item. If I go back to the page, you'll now see that my content has been repeated multiple times and forms a list. I'm just going to fix something here because I left a margin, but actually you don't want to do that. By default, the repeater will display your items vertically, but you can change the display in the Style tab of the inspector on the right. You can change the background color, border, corner radius, and padding of the repeater, so this is going to affect everything. Just to show you, if I add a padding, it's not actually adding a padding between each item. You see here it's still stuck together. It's adding a padding around the whole repeater widget. Same thing if you add borders, it's not going to add borders to each item, but to the whole list. The options below the padding, however, are focused on each item. So you can decide the layout of the repeater. Do you want a vertical list or a horizontal list? So since I have three items in here, now I have a horizontal list. Notice there's some artifacts sometimes that remain here, but don't worry, it won't show in the prototype. And if you just refresh the page, they'll disappear. You can also wrap this as a grid. So let's say I only want to have two items in each row. Then I can do that and it will automatically place the last item in the new position. You can use an item background or alternate item backgrounds. So let's say we alternate item backgrounds. Some of them should have a gray background, others should have a white background. So you can do every other one. You can simulate having multiple pages and only display a part of the items that are contained in your list, but we're not going to look into it right now. Just remember it exists, and it's a nice way of controlling how many items you're displaying. The last fields control how much space is displayed in between different items, be it rows or columns, and this is what you're going to use to style your repeater most. You'll probably need more than three items in your list, so in order to add some, go to the Properties tab. Scroll down until you see the table and add as many rows as you want to have items. What is inside the rows doesn't really matter at this point. I added three rows, so now I have six items total in my list, and I can go back to the styling to have three on each line. Using repeaters is a really fast way to create clean-looking lists. It works best when the content of your list looks really similar all the time. If some of the content has to look very different, or if the length of the text varies a lot, then it's better to copy-paste content or use different types of masters to create a list. If your list items contain dynamic panels and are supposed to change in size, I also don't recommend using repeaters because their size will not adjust automatically. Using repeaters is a really fast way to generate a list. But the strength of the repeater is that you'll actually later be able to add real content inside the list and simulate all the features of faceted search, sorting, and displaying different pages of results. So it's mostly useful when you're making a user testing prototype. Thanks for watching and see you next time!